Shalom friends, this is Mir Neshama for Or Halev. This week we're reading Parashat Vayetse. And as we are entering the month of Kislev, which according to the Sefer Yetzirah is the month of sleep, we see the parasha opening with Yaakov going to sleep. And Yaakov goes to sleep and Yaakov wakes up. And when he wakes up, he has what we can call a spiritual awakening. And he says, Achen, yesh Hashem b'makom hazeh, v'anochi lo yadati. Indeed, there is God in this place, and I didn't know. And that's very much the notion of spiritual awakening right there. This notion that awakening is not something that we reach, something new that we find. It's more realizing that what we were looking for was already there, and we simply wake up to that truth. And in many world traditions, there is this kind of metaphor for the spiritual journey between a state of sleep and a state of awakening. And so we could think that this metaphor is being explained here or shown here in a way that is very literal with the sleep of Yaakov and he's waking up. But actually there is something in the Jewish tradition that makes sleep actually a very propitious context for spiritual awakening instead of the opposite of it. The Talmud reminds us that, considers dreams as a 60th of prophecy. And so according to the Talmudic sage, within the state of sleep, what happens there is a space open for possibilities that don't exist in the kind of normal awake state. And the Rabbi Mipiezetzner, the Esh Kodesh, whom we love very much at Or Halev, when he teaches Hashkata, his meditation technique, the quieting technique Hashkata, starts with this. He starts with this quote from the Talmud, reminding us that the dream is a 60th of prophecy, because to him it's relevant in the sense that when we dream, the ego is kind of more relaxed. The ego is more relaxed. And when the ego is kind of like not on the front scene, then we're more open, more receptive for prophecy nevuah, which really is what he calls Ashra'ah Memarom, receiving inspiration from above. And that's the Kavana I wanted to share with you this week, is may we invest in our sleep, and especially, you know, it may seem relevant now as we're getting slowly entering into the winter, a time where the night takes more space in our days, and we're invited to sleep more, also just to take care of our bodies and the kind of natural rhythms of the body and nature. To invest in our sleeps in a way that is receptive, so that we may receive the messages, the inspiration that we're meant to receive. Shabbat Shalom.